First title bout of the evening, 5 1.5 minute rounds, matched at 41k, Mila Tyler, Hodre in the blue, Leaper Barbate, Diesel in the red. So, KBX title at stake for these two youngsters. Mila Tyler will be the taller of the two, with those blue gloves. Leaper Barbate slightly short with those red gloves, and it's Mila that comes across very quickly and backs Leaper up in her own corner, not giving her time to get into this bout so far. Looks quickly to a corner, just gives Leaper time to regroup, but Mila set out a stall early, looking to use that height and reach advantage to back Leaper up. Leaper working her own jab now. Mila steps in that left, finds the target, pushes forward once more. Good footwork from Leaper as she backs up, waits for Mila to come in. Mila takes her time, no rushing. Steps forward again, throws the low kick, then the straight right to the face. Backs Leaper up in her own corner, and these are heavy shots as she looks to keep the combinations coming. And Leaper tucks up tightly. These are hard, heavy shots from the first count for the red corner, as Mila really came in and stayed in the pocket and kept the pressure on. Leaper forced to suck it up now, taking deep breaths to recover. Garth looking at her constantly, and he'll be talking to her constantly as well. Checking she's okay, she's saying she is. Gutsy competitor. That's a big opening round now for the blue corner, and she'll look to capitalize and come straight back in. And Leaper forced to back up again. Mila steps in and out, little shimmies now, very confident as she comes forward, throwing these left and rights. And I think there's going to be a second count here for Leaper. Well, he's going to at least adjust the head guard as he talks to her guard. And she is getting a second count, so it's a big opening round for the Hodre fighter in the blue corner. Little shimmy again as she comes forward, using that height and reach well, snaps Leaper's head back. It's a gutsy performance from the young lady in the red, but this young lady set out a stall early, used that height and reach, got two counts for her part. Leaper very game to want to continue, corner talking to her. She's going to have to get more of an offensive game if she's going to stay in this bout. She has to start asking questions of Mila. Stop her coming forward at will. Got to keep her back. Can't afford to let Mila get up ahead of steam and stay in the pocket there. Little feints with the stamps there from Mila. Lipa circling once more. Mila just taking her time. This is better from Lipa though. She's got to get an offensive movement going. She's got to come forward. Can't afford to be backed up like this. Mila stalking once more, taking her time. Backing Lipa up once more, looking to get her in the corner, then work. Again. Steps forward once more, throws the low kick, push kick from Lipa, but takes another low kick as Mila comes in, looks for the knee, readjusts the head guard. There's that shimmy and that little stamp from Mila, taking her time. She knows she's in control at the moment. And this is where Lipa's got to find something to take her out of her comfort zone. Easier said than done for me. I'm sat in a commentary position. I'm safe. I'm not taking punishment. But you can't afford this. Lipa's got to try and find a way to take Mila out of her comfort zone. But I've got a feeling it's going to be a hard night's work from the young lady in the red corner. Because at the moment, Mila Tyler is operating well within her comfort zone, using that height and reach. And Lipa Barbate, very gutsy. But it's a rear guard action. It's a defensive action here in this title as we approach the midway point, round three. They touch gloves. And Mila throws that low kick as Lipa looks to come forward for the first time. And this is right. She's got to do it. She's got to try and put Mila under pressure. And to her credit, that's what she's trying here at the first seconds of this third round, but Mila immediately turns it on its head again and pushes forward. Straight and accurate and focused, as you can see. And immediately Lipa is under pressure once more. She tried to turn things around right at the beginning, but Mila immediately got back on that front foot. Lipa, it's been a gutsy performance. She's been under pressure, but she's stuck to the task. But Mila, for her part, has put the combinations together, stayed in the pocket, and continued to back her opponent up with combinations like this. Garth looking very closely at Lipa now, as she's backed up in her own corner, and this could be it. She's going to get another count. She's under real pressure here. She's not asking for any favours. Look, she's still here. Garth's looking closely. I think he's going to give her one more chance, he's saying, here in the third. And Mila, you know, will step on the gas once more. She'll look to back Lipa up again and push forward. And Garth looking closely as Mila does so. What a gutsy performance from Lipa. She's asked for no favours, but she's found herself backed up here far too often in this title bout. Breathes deeply. Doesn't look to come forward as Mila comes in again. And I think Garth's seen enough here. Yeah, good call by our referee, Garth. Great refereeing there. Gutsy performance from Lipa, but Mila is going to get that title belt around her waist.
The KBX title belt goes around the waist of the fighter from the blue.
You can see what it means to Mila Tyler there. Gutsy performance from Lipa, but Mila was in control of that from the opening bell.